So I have a client from India. Mm. This is his third condominium.
Okay.
Okay. I know, but I don't say, so how come got pineapple? So I don't know. The neighbor also throw pineapple, the upstairs also, so I also throw pineapple.
Hi everyone, I'm Praveena and I'm at Circle96 LLP. And here I am with Master KK. Very important to choose the right home. So what are some do's and don'ts that you can share with the audience?
Okay, I'm going to share a few personal stories.
Okay.
When Master Sharon and I got married, we bought a house in Changi Gardens. It's just off Upper Changi Road. And we bought a house, we were doing okay. We all started with these vans, my business was doing good.
Mm.
3 years down the road, we can't even afford the installment for the house. And of course the car hire, which is so was towed away twice. What went wrong? The environment. Okay? So Changi Gardens is just opposite Changi Prison.
Oh, okay.
So when you purchase a house, try not to go near any unauspicious area. Mm. Prisons, detention camp,
cemetery,
boys' home, exactly. Okay. So crematorium.
Yeah.
You remember there was once Punggol, the crematorium issue so big that the minister could come and address it?
Yes.
That must be a reason why.
Mm-hmm.
So try not to go to an auspicious place.
Mm-hmm.
So now they tore down the whole place, they unblocked it, and it's called Park Como.
Oh.
So I did a video again about Park Como personal experience.
Okay.
And then last week someone texted me, I have purchased, and what should I do?
Oh.
I said, I'm sorry, please come look for me. Okay. Yeah, so try not to get anywhere that's not auspicious.
Okay.
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 Cemetery is one of them, obviously. Mm-hmm. Actually.
Yeah. I mean, yes.
Yeah. Okay. It's obvious, isn't it?
Yeah. Any other do's and don'ts?
Okay.
Maybe one more?
Yeah, good. A lot of people have this misperception that hospital is not good. On the contrary, it's pretty good.
Really?
Yes.
But there's so many deaths and...
Yes. There's also births.
Ah,
there are also
yes,
people who got killed.
Don't focus on the negative.
Yes. It's how you focus it. So that's an easy condominium just outside Sengkang.
Uh-huh.
The south of the condominium is the hospital. Hospital is fire element, so the south is also fire element, so it's very good. So the second daughter in the family are usually the one more compassionate. The year 2014 is also a good year, which is going to be year 2026 in 12 years' time. It's going to be generally a good year.
Oh.
The south is also your lottery lock. It's also your documentation, your academic star. So you have fire there, it's very good.
Okay.
So do not be misguided. That's a lot of misperception.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, don't believe that.
I mean, you wouldn't really know about all this on yourself, so you definitely need to meet him and get some tips.
Definitely.
Alright, so is there any pantang in feng shui? You know, taboo.
Taboo, yes.
Yeah, the common ones.
Alright, the people who say, can we not see feng shui in the middle of the night? I say, yes, technically you can. But because it's a new house, there's no lights. How do you go see your house if there's no lights? You're not, electricity is not, it's not fixed up. So if a client, a gentleman, he insists to have his house audited. Right? I said, no, I can't. You've got no lights.
Mm.
And I turned that deal down. You know, so are there any taboos? Technically, no. But I'll tell you some myth that I wish to address it.
Okay, of course.
Yeah. When you move your house, you don't have to throw pineapple. That's a myth.
People do that.
All the time.
Throw pineapple. I heard pineapples are very bad to keep in the house or something. Is it?
No, it's not. So a lot of Chinese believe that if you roll or toss your pineapple into the house, it brings wealth.
Oh.
If that is so easy, I'll give you one lorry or pineapple, you start throwing into your house and you see whether wealth will come to you or not. Okay? No. So I have a client from India.
Mm.
This is his third condominium.
Okay.
Okay? I know. But I don't say, so how come got pineapple? I say, I don't know. The neighbor also throw pineapple, the upstairs also, so I also throw pineapple. So this is a myth, okay, don't do that, okay? But if you have tossed your pineapple, bring it home and eat, it's okay.
Okay.
It's not that something you cannot eat,
okay?
But I would strongly suggest you don't have to.
Yeah.
And stop throwing or sprinkle rice and salt.
Yeah,
in the
salt.
House. Yeah, don't.
At the corners especially.
Correct.
You know?
So if these are food, you know, they're precious food.
Yeah.
So put them in a packet or in a Ziploc and then you place, if you have to, just place them. But I strongly suggest no, Okay, because this is Taoism practice, so I'm not going to criticize anything.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but these are food. You don't want to waste them. Mm. There are people who goes hungry in earth, and if you did not sweep your sword clean, you will corrode your parquet.
Oh, now you know.
So don't do that. Okay, now don't do that.
Because they usually just leave it there and they don't sweep it.
Right, exactly. So it eats into your parquet, it eats into your vinyl and things like that. Yeah, okay. So don't do that. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Good. So you mentioned that Feng Shui is not a religion, but many people still take it as a religion. Mm. Can you shed some light on this?
Well, it's because of the Taoism symbol. Mm. We share the same symbol as the Taoists I just mentioned. They borrowed, they never returned. They have not returned, not never, they have not returned. I don't think they'll return it anytime soon. Uh-huh. Okay? So that's give us a wrong, many people a wrong impression. So was I also misguided, you know? So, but again, it's not religious. Feng Shui has no religion involved in it. Some practices bring religion to it. I'm not going to say why, I'm not going to criticize them. But if environment has no religion. 8,000 years ago, we were fishing and we were hunting. There was no religion. There was not even a literacy.
Yeah.
So that's no religion. The longest religion is not even 8,000 years.
Isn't it Buddhism that is the longest?
No, it's Judaism.
Oh, Judaism. Okay. Something new.
Something new. That's right.
All right.
Yeah.
So that's a wrap for today's episode, but that's more about Feng Shui. So do tune in next week for more about Feng Shui. See you next time. Bye.